Being the oldest of six kids can be tough, but it can also serve as a foundation for skills to be used later in life, like leadership and confidence. Those were two of the many traits Ken O'Brien had. Born in New York, Ken moved to Sacramento when he was 3 years old and lived in the Arden Oaks area. He went to St. Ignatius and later to Jesuit High School. It was there Ken started to develop into one of the best quarterbacks the area has ever seen. Learning from coaches Red Smith, Dan Carmazzi, Hank Meyer, and Dick Spurbeck, he began his record-setting journey. He started his college career at Sacramento State, but his time was short-lived there as head coach Bob Matos was running the run-oriented Veer offense that didn't showcase the rifle arm that Ken possessed. Ken felt it was in his best interest to transfer to a more quarterback-friendly environment. That place was UC Davis. With legendary coach Jim Soaker designing the offense, it was time for Air O'Brien. Ken flourished at UC Davis, leading the Aggies to a perfect 10-0 regular season record in 1982 and led them to the Division II National Championship game. During his senior season, he was ranked number 2 in total offense and number 3 in passing efficiency in the country. During his college career, he was selected as All-Far Western Conference quarterback 3 times. After suffering a broken leg prior to the championship game, Ken was questioning his draft status. Would the NFL take an injured kid from a small Division II school that not many people heard of? On April 26, 1983, Ken was about to take a Spanish test. At 7 a.m., he got a phone call that would change his life. The New York Jets selected Ken O'Brien with the 24th overall pick of the NFL draft. The kid who was born in New York was going back to his roots. The 1983 draft was one for the record books. It was the only draft that featured 6 quarterbacks taken in the first round, and Sacramento had 2 of them. Besides O'Brien, Delta High School product Tony Eason was also selected. The first round featured John Elway, Todd Blackledge, Jim Kelly, and the man who was selected 3 picks after Ken, none other than Dan Marino. In this one single round, 4 quarterbacks went to the Super Bowl, 4 went to the Pro Bowl, and 3 are in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. Ken had an outstanding career with the Jets and was the franchise's most successful quarterback since Joe Namath. In 1985, he was the highest-rated QB in the NFL and retired as the only Jets quarterback to hold this honor. In the 85 season, he guided the Jets to an 11-5 record and was named AFC Player of the Year. In 1986, he led the Jets to the best record in the league after 11 games, as they were 10-1. Ken also held the team record for most consecutive passes in a single game, 17 straight. He was the first NFL quarterback to pass for over 400 yards in a game and have a perfect passer rating of 158.3. Ken had an incredible 11-year NFL career, passing for over 25,000 yards and 128 touchdowns while being selected to 2 Pro Bowls. In 1990, the first NFL quarterback challenge was introduced. The made-for-TV event featured several top-rated QBs competing in several events, with Ken emerging as the champion. After his playing days, he appeared on TV and also got into coaching as quarterback's coach at his alma mater, UCD, and at USC, where he developed Heisman Trophy winner and NFL Pro Bowler Carson Palmer. Ken O'Brien will always be known as one of the most prolific quarterbacks to ever come from the Sacramento area. He's a member of the College Football Hall of Fame and the Cal Aggie Athletic Hall of Fame. And now, it is our honor to induct Ken O'Brien into the Sacramento Sports Hall of Fame.